for you.
So much, amen. And the thing I love about God, and this is what I have to tell him, I wish I could give this testimony. He said, the thing I love about God, oh, but I'm going to take a risk on this because you need to hear it. You know, the thing I love about God, friend, is you won't be standing on, is that God honors his word. Even when you and I don't.
Amen.
When God said, when you come to Christ, you're faultless before me, he means that. You may not accept it, but he means it. So it does not matter my lifestyle.
Amen.
When I come in, I'm accepted. I am perfected. It does not matter my habits. It matters to you because you didn't write my prescription. So when I come in, I'm on a prescription from God. So I may not be you, but I don't have your purpose. You may not have to suffer what I suffer because you don't have my purpose. So I can't get mad if you don't go through what I go through. I don't even need to suffer. You think he's special because he went through so much, everybody went through it. You're right, you don't have to go through it.
Amen.
Because you don't have my purpose.
Amen.
That's no reason in church. Oh, you're going to go through something. It may be private. But you, I ain't going there because I'm not going to be mature enough for that. Everybody in here got something you're battling. Can I say that again? I'm going to say the boldness. If you hear me, say amen.
Amen.
Every African American, Jamaican American, Indian American, Haitian American, and anything else in between, if you can hear my voice, you have something going on with you. You don't want everybody to know.
That's true.
It may be private and nobody will ever see it. But God places in your life to get you where you need to go.
Amen.
Wow. And what I love about general love is that you can come in here and not pretend.
Amen.
So let me give this testimony that I got from one of our members, you know. One of a friend is a member of this church now. But she got word that her friend was about to die, get everybody to the hospital. And she went to the hospital, but she didn't go for no death. She went because she had done something. She understood that she had power.
Amen. Amen.
That's what we teach you here. She understood that she had power. Now they both members of this church. And I can't wait till Thursday to close my testimony. The clicker is, she's a lesbian. Oh, they got real quiet. Because you have not enough faith to do it. Don't judge who God is using. Because somebody come and be perfected in Christ. Have faith in God.
Amen.
As I'm walking in my power. And you trust in them, and you want to go through it.
Amen.
Everybody, please clap your hands. I do crazy stuff like that. I do crazy stuff like that. You know what? Because I told God I'm going to live the truth. I'm not going to be intimidated by your faith. Reality is, when you come in Christ, in truth, you are empowered by the Holy Ghost to go and be a witness unto Christ. Yeah. Everyone here right now, you have somebody sick at your home, have some faith and go lay hands on them. You didn't call people like this altar before. Praying for them and sending home to pray for their sick ones. And the sick people got them on the bed. Why do I give these testimonies? Because we live in truth and genuine love. And I'm going to give the testimony. It is my plan, at least in North Carolina on the 7th or whatever night that is. I'm going to get up. Because somebody, gentlemen, please pray for me. Listen to me, man. I feel my heart is bleeding. Somebody got to stand up and tell people the truth.
Amen. Amen.
That's why when the preacher have a fault, everybody still want to stop going to church. Listen. Going there.